Hello and welcome to the Linux Panic YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to install Arch Linux from start to login. So let's get into it. The first thing we need to do is we need to get the most up-to-date version of the Arch Linux ISO. In this case, it is 2023-0101, and that's what I'll be using here, and that is using the most up-to-date Linux kernel. So let's get booted into it. First thing we need to do is wait for the boot process to start. Go through the process. We get a little hello, welcome to Arch Linux. Goes through doing the usual boot up things. I swear it takes longer to boot into Arch Linux than it does to my own system. As we can see here, we are using the 6.1.1 kernel of Linux. So let's begin. We have a couple of things to do first. Make sure we're connected to internet. We can do that with ping 1.1.1.1, ping Cloudflare, 19 millisecond ping. Not often you see that with Cloudflare, so that's interesting. Play the screen, and now let's start with partitioning our disk. The first thing we need to do is list the blocks. As we can see here, we have a 816 megabyte ROM, a 702 megabyte loop, and 40 gigabyte disk, and that's what we're going to be running off of. First thing, after we've listed the block size, now we need to do cfdisk. We need to choose a label type, general partition table, DOS, SGI, and Sun Systems. In this case, we're going to be using DOS, as our disk size is less than 2 terabytes. Now that we're here, we need to do a few things. We need to set a boot partition. In this case, it's going to be 128 megabytes. And we will select that as our primary. And hit B. As we can see here, there's a little asterisk that has just appeared. And that indicates we've made that as our boot space. Then we want to select free space. Select yes. Select enter as primary. As we can see here, we have the second partition that fills up the rest of the space. Now what we want to do is we now want to select write and then quit. Or write and then yes and then quit. So we want to come across to here. We need to type yes, otherwise this won't write at all. As we can see here, partition table has been altered. We select quit. Clear our screen, list the blocks, and as we can see here, VDA1, virtual disk A1 and virtual disk A2, that's what we want. Because I'm using Vert Manager, it's VDA1, VDA2. For you, it might be SDA1 or SDA2, or how you have your disks set up. Now that we've done that, we need to make the file system for our blocks. And we're going to be making them in the ext4 format. So to do that, we need to do mkfs.ext4. /dev/VDA1. As we can see here, that went through with no problems. And VDA2. That's done that. And we have a look again. As we can see here, still just VDA1 and 2, nothing's just changed. That's because we've made the file system. Now we need to mount them. So to do that, we need to put them in a certain location. So for our second block, as it is, that's just the mount partition. We do that with mount /dev/VDA2. In my case, it's VDA. For you, it might be SDA/MNT. We make a directory /MNT/boot for VDA1. Again, this might be different for you. And we now want to mount /dev/VDA1 to /MNT/boot and list our blocks. And as we can see here, VDA1 for our boot partition is correct, and VDA2 for where everything else goes in mount is also correct. So what we can now do is just clear. That's time we download what we need and get everything ready. So to do that, we use the wonderful tool of packstrap. So we do packstrap /MNT/ base, base devel, the base development Linux, Linux firmware, and we'll just use Vim in this case. As we can see here, it's going to go through the process of downloading everything. Total download size 548.88 MB, with a total install size of 1247.25 MB. As we can see here, it's flying through. We did not set up the parallel downloads for Arch Linux, but in the case of me, I don't need the parallel downloads because it's fast. My internet connection is fast enough as is. As we can see here, it's going through the process, getting everything set up, appending the GPG keys, and just going through the process of finishing off installing, doing its usual checking, making sure everything's set up, getting all the build hooks sorted out, checking for any issues, as we can see here, possibly missing firmware module 4, BFA, QLA, AIC. It's not chucked an error, but as we can see here, this took a total of 21.29 seconds, which is not bad at all, or 59 seconds total time. It adds in some extra information for the computer. Now that we've done that, everything is A-OK, and we can now move on to getting things set up. So now we want to set up a FS tab. We can do that with gen FS tab hyphen U, capital U, slash MNT, double arrow, into slash MNT, slash ETC, slash FS tab. And if nothing comes up saying there's been an error, it has worked, and there's been no issue, which is good. Now we need to do arch hyphen chroot slash mnt slash bin bash. We're currently in the actual installed operating system before we move on, which is good. As we can see here, the root at arch ISO is no longer red. It means we're in the live system, so if we make a mistake, we've made a mistake. The first thing we're going to do is we're just going to do pacman hyphen s network manager and grub. And that's just going to download and install grub and set up the networking stuff. Again, fly through, no bother. Now we need to enable network manager. See, as you can see here, network manager is one word, no capitals. But when getting it enabled, we need to add the capitals. So to do that, we do system DTL enable network manager. And that'll enable the networking stuff. As we can see here, it's created the sim links. It's gone through and just set everything up as we want it to. And that is good. And now I want to install grub in our Dart, in our, on our VDA disk, as we can see here. VDA, for you it might be SDA or however your disks are set up. But in my case, because it's VDA, we want to do grub install slash dev slash VDA. As we can see here, installing for 32-bit platform and no errors reported, which is good. We want to make a grub config, and we can do that with grub mkconfig hyphen o base slash boot slash grub.cfg or grub config. Went through, no issues, which is good. Now we want to add a password, so we do pass wd. Gonna ask a password. I'm just gonna do arch password updated successfully, no problems. We now need to sort out the locale settings, so like keyboard and times and languages and all that. So to do that, we can do vim slash etc slash locale dot gen. And as we can see here, this is just listing off all of the keyboard types in the ISO and UTF-8 format. Because I'm using a English US keyboard, we can see there are two standards. There's the UTF-8 standard, and then there is the ISO 8859 standard. In my case, I'm just going to be using the UTF-8 standard. So we want to come here, hit insert, get rid of that, Control C, colon, right, quit, exclamation mark. That says, do it without messing me about. Problem solved. Now we need to generate the locale information. We can do locale, hyphen gen. And the generation for locales is complete. Now we need to set up the locale config. And we can do that with vim /etc/locale.conf. Correction, locale.gen. I made a small mistake. Do QA. As we can see here, not locale.conf, locale.gen. No, it is locale.conf. I was reading my own instructions wrong. So, this is where we learn. That's okay. So now that we've done our getting the keyboard sorted out, we now need to do locale.conf. And we need to type in lang equals en hyphen us dot utf-8. If we use the ISO standard as well, we would have to put in the ISO standard here as well. But because we didn't, we don't have to. Do right quit. And as we can see, it was written with no issues, which is good. So now we're going to add a host name. In this case, it's just going to be Arch for me, but you can choose whatever you want. The host name. I'm just going to do Arch, Control C, colon, right quit, exclamation mark, screen. And now we need to set up our time zone. So this is where it would be ideal to know what your time zone is. You can tab through, but in my case, my time zone is LN. To set up my time zone, I do LN-SF, user, share, zone, /America. Yep, if I could spell. Oh my lord. America. And because there are many time zones in America, I could choose through several. But in my case, because I'm in the New York time zone, I just do /new_York/etc/local time. And that's set up. Now all we have to do is just type exit back here, unmount -r/nt, yes, and just reboot. And now we want to boot from the virtual disk. Here we have an Arch Linux install as intended. And it's just the password is just Arch. I meant the password is Arch, not the login, so it's just going to be, oh lord. We will do root Arch. As we can see, all sorted out, so we're just going to do pacman-s neofetch. Install the package. Quick neofetch. And here we are, a perfectly installed system from start to finish with no issues at all, running on the latest kernel of 6.1.3-arch1-1 for the first ISO install of 2023 even. Holy hell. If you found this video useful, give it a thumbs up. If you dislike the video, hit the dislike button. They both work. I can only see all of them, but you can't see them at all. And if you found this video useful, give it a subscribe as well. Anyway, I have been Nick. You have been amazing, and I hope you have a good rest of your day. Goodbye.